What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about hiding the try the new Outlook within Outlook, that little toggle at the upper right-hand side using Intune. So let's get right into it. All right, so before we even start, I'm going to show you what I mean. This is what I mean right there. Try the new Outlook. You want to remove that, right? I think on the last video, we did it through a group policy, and today is all about creating an Intune policy. So let's get into our Microsoft 365 Admin Center. Within here on the left-hand side, we're going to click on Show All. We're going to locate and click on Microsoft Intune. So locate it and click on it. It's going to take you here. So we are going to click on Devices on the left-hand side. Click on Devices. And underneath By Platform, let's click on Windows. And underneath Manage Devices, click on Configuration. Now within here, we're going to see a big button that says Create. So click on that. It's going to give you a nice little drop down. We are going to select New Policy. It's going to give you a side menu for the platform. We are going to click on the drop down and we are going to select Windows 10 and later. For the profile type, we're going to click on that and we're going to select Settings Catalog. All the way in the bottom, click on Create. Now let's give it a name. I gave it the following, pretty self-explanatory. And once you give it a name, we're going to click on Next. Now for the configuration settings, right there where it says Add Settings, that is a hyperlink. Click on that. You're going to get another side menu. And I'm going to type in Outlook. Just type in Outlook and just click on Search. Once you click on Search, it's going to give you a bunch of stuff. We are going to locate the following. Microsoft Outlook 2016, Outlook Options and Other. So we're going to select that. It's going to give you a bunch of other things underneath. And the one that we need to locate would be the following. Hide the Try the New Outlook toggle in Outlook for users. So give it a check mark. Now, for some reason within this part here, there's no OK. So we need to go at the upper right hand side where the X is at. Just click on it to close it. Now we have the setting. By default, this is what you get. It's disabled. So slide that to your right to enable it. Bingo. We're going to click on Next. I typically don't have tags, so I just click Next here. For the assignment, I am going to select Add a Group. You're going to get a side menu. I have a particular group that I want to assign this stuff into, and it is called BTNHD Devices Testing Only because I want to test it out first before I deploy it to the masses. Click on Select. Awesome. From here, let's click on Next. Right, click on Next. So it's time for us to review and create. So review it. Once you're satisfied, click on the button that says Create. On the upper right-hand side, it is going to state Policy Created. It was done successfully. Give it some time. It should load up. And there goes the policy. Now, the machine that I have that's within that particular security group is this machine. If we go into that machine, this is the machine right here. If you do a forced sync or just give it some time for the machine to talk to your tenant, eventually what's going to happen is that policy will be pushed down. And if you open up Outlook on that machine, you're going to see on the upper right-hand side that the toggle is gone. Awesome. So hopefully you guys enjoy this video and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.